And then I didn't work, I didn't seek employment after that. We started a few things. We started the media agency, we tried, it was a PR firm, we worked there for a bit, things didn't pan out. Then
you met Boni in
2006.
2006,
yes.
While working for?
At the time when I was working for Amani Ajo. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Can you remember the first meet?
Yes, when I met him.
Yeah.
Yes, like yesterday. Like it
How
was
did
yesterday.
It happen? How did it happen?
We left church, it was on a Sunday. Mm-hmm. We left church in Mavuno Church. We were so many of us. The topic in church that season was Sex in the City. There was a story called Sex in the City, the series on TV, also called Sex in the City. And I think the controversy was like, oh my God, Ikanisa, Jamini, what is this they're talking about? So because of that controversy, I was of the idea that people in church are so holy and shpiri that we cannot talk about these things, yet this is the life that people are living. People are cohabiting, people are living together when they're not married. So they don't want that to be touched. Let's not discuss that at all. Because church should not focus on things like that. But I was like, it is the reality of our lives. Let's talk about it. You know, there's what the Bible says about it. There's how we are living. So where do we reconcile? Do we want to live the way the Bible is saying? Or do we acknowledge the Bible says this, but I choose to live outside of that and I'm cool with it, you know? So that's the debate, argument, not argument, that was the conversation we were having. So we went to Steers to have ice cream. It was bong off, buy one get one free. So we sat there, and I remember we were in the upstairs on Steers Obera, and Boni came up the stairs, and I was, so he came up from behind me, and we were seated in a big table. So he
Wabera
comes
Street.
Wabera Street, uh-huh. the stairs that used to be at I think City House at that corner.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm seated, and the stairs were behind me. So this guy comes this way, and from the corner of my eye, I see a helmet. There was also a program called Renegade.
Mm-hmm.
Renegade was, he was a cop and good at his job, but he committed the ultimate crime, cops gone back. I used to love it because of the guy who used to ride that bike, and the way he used to have a ponytail, and because he was, you know, it was an interesting story. So this guy comes in, and from the corner of my eye, I see a helmet and a leather jacket. Hey, everything disappeared. Like it was just me and this guy. He didn't walk up to me. He came, walked around the table, went to the end of that table, spoke hush 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 to someone. I don't remember what we were talking. I forgot what I was saying. I don't remember whether I said anything after he came in. Then after a short while, the guy left. I was like, what? Ivo too would be a Mikey many Peter. No, we were like 15.
15 of you.
Yeah, we were having a conversation about church and this topic that church has decided to talk about. So he came and left. I don't remember whether our eyes locked. I just remember thinking, I would really, really like to meet that guy, you know. Your story can share hivo. Because I was not going to ask for his number. I don't know this guy. You know, it was like Renegade, like a character out of a movie and then gone back into the movie. Me, I continued my life. So the guy he came and talked to told me that he had asked for my number because this guy is a photographer and he's looking for a model because he takes photos for Pulse magazine. I was like, what does that have to do with me? He said, yeah, he was thinking that maybe you could be a model. For, I was like, wait, Mimi, model. Like, wow. Wow. Mimi, sasa. So I was like, okay, if I'll get to meet him, I'll probably not make it to the newspaper for sure because me, I'm not model material. But yeah, if he wants to meet me, yeah, give him my number, let him call me. So he didn't call me for like a month. That's his story to tell. He just didn't know what to say to me. So when he finally found an excuse and a reason to call me, he called me and told me he was looking for someone to shoot for cover for the magazine, Pulse magazine. And I said, no. How much are you paying? He said, no, we don't pay. He said, okay, you don't have to pay, but you have a bike, you have something I want. I just want a ride, just one ride, you and your malipo. If you give me a ride, then you can shoot, we can do it. It will probably not be accepted, because me, I'm not model material, but yeah, so. So he said, yeah, just that's all you want. I said, yeah, I just want a ride. So he gave me a ride. I remember we went to Sides of Junction. I do not remember where exactly, if we stopped, if we ate or drank anything. May I just remember the ride on Gong Road, because I screamed all the way. I was living in Buru. Yeah. I was living in Buru. I screamed all the way in excitement. I was really excited. So when we went back home, like I said, I don't remember whether we talked about anything when we went. I don't remember where we went, where we if we sat, if we shukad the bike, tulienda tukazunguka hapo tukarudi. But I remember we got home at about 10 going to 11. I was living with some friends of mine. So because it was late, I was like, of course, see, tutaongea hapa aishie because it's late, sitaki kumweka. Hey, we talked until like 2. Hapo tu kwa gate. Until 2 in the morning. From but this is my house. Yeah. This, I didn't think we were going to stay that long. I did not mean to invite him in. I just didn't think we were going to talk that long.
Yeah.
Plus my adrenaline. Ilikuwa hapa hivi at the, if I would have been pricked like this, the blood would have just shot out. I was too excited. But I remember the conversation we had that day outside our gate. That just made me think, wow, this guy is something else. He was, I felt like my life was very monotonous, you know, just wake up, sleep, wake up, sleep. Like, I didn't feel like my life was meaningful, so to speak, at the time. So when I met Boni and that several hours of conversation outside our gate, and he told me about his life, how he's grown up, that he's, you know, there was a time he was in the streets, that he really wanted to be a leader in this country so that he can help youth not live the way he lived. He said, maybe if I'm open to it, he can take me where he grew up. I was like, wow, me, I've never heard things like this. Like, for real, like, your life is a storybook. Because me, I considered myself, and I still do consider myself, I grew up privileged. We're not rich, but I grew up privileged. And I don't take that for granted. I think my parents really worked very hard, like I said, to even take us to good schools. And maybe we were shielded by the fact that we were in boarding school, so we didn't see our parents struggling to a certain extent. We were focused and busy in school, just kusoma, cleaning, and whatever comes with boarding school. So when he told me all these things, I was like, wow, I was completely blown away. But I knew at that point that we could not have a relationship. This guy is on the fast lane. He's focused, he knows what he wants in life. Me, I am okay just living, just going around like this, chasing my own tail, you know, not living a meaningful life. So I knew when we could not be, we were not compatible in any sense. I completely admired him, and I told him, I really wish you all the best. You know, when you make it, uko, remember, when you look in the watus, uko kwa crowd, just know there's like a chick you met once, and I'll be rooting for you. So, he did take the photo. I'll find it for you. I can share it with you. And then my mother, when my parents saw it, they were like, what? Is your sister okay? When did you last talk to her? My dad saw it and said, in Kikuyu, ha-ha, ni haka umodo. Like, here, something will come out of this. I'm not sure what he meant. Maybe it was a blessing in disguise that he did not know he was blessing me. Because then we started dating. Because you see, out here he's fighting, literally fighting a system and injustices. Those don't exist in our house. Yeah. At home, he's just my pal. He's the kid's father. He's a father and a husband, and a friend. Yeah.
Totally different.
Yeah, totally different. He laughs a lot.
Mm.
Yeah. The things, the injustices are what just makes him sad.
What does he love doing at home? Cooking?
He loves cooking. He loves making nyama.
Mm.
Yeah, and he makes really good meat. He makes a mean roast.
That is his best meal.
That's his best meal. Anything that is nyama, he can do anything with nyama. Whether it is boiling it, and I don't know what things he puts in it. But him and nyama, he's found a space there that he really enjoys doing. And he also enjoys entertaining friends, like when...
Road safety ambassador.
So because we have lost many friends, but I think the thing that really threw me off into the craze of road safety was losing a very close friend called James Quest in 2016. When you look at the roads, the way they're built, the way first of all, how we appear on our roads. I'm a pedestrian, I'm a cyclist, I don't cycle much, but there are people who cycle, there are people on wheelchairs, there are drivers, there are bikers, there are mkokotenis. But the way our roads are made, they don't have regard for all of these users. Some places do, but not most, yeah? And especially not the places where they need to be that way. You'll have some of these roads in Kilimani areas, but where there's crowds and matatus and that craze, it's just big enough for matatus. So there's bikers and all these other people that show up in the road. The way they're made and the way we present ourselves, first of all, the roads are not right for us, because we can't all be in that space. We are at different speeds, we're using different machines, yeah? But also, the people are not responsible. You will drive drunk, you will walk drunk, just, you know, as if you're in a park. You will ride drunk. Then at night, the government has not made it possible. Visibility is an issue. Our roads are not properly marked. As with all the thrills, I chose Boni and everything that came with Boni. Yeah, I knew about how he grew up. I chose that. I could have said, "Wah, mimi siendi na mtu ajui akusoma mpaka uni, siendi na mtu from a broken family." I mean, I'd have done all those things, but I chose this man. So I knew who I chose, and like I said, Boni has always been consistent. He's always kept his word. He may delay, but Boni is a man of his word. So I never for one moment thought, no, stop this. I was like, we need to change tactic. We need to change tactic. And we've always fought over that. This, I think we could do this differently. Yeah. So that's something we've disagreed about. But even when he decides to go the way he will go, I'm like, sawa basi.
So that Jamhuri Day, how many people were supposed to be at that stadium?
I was smitten. I just, anything angesema, 20, sawa, whatever. There was no crime. If there was a crime, it was loving him, because then there was nothing he would say or do that could be wrong. I was taken in completely. Kumezwa.
So you had no difficulty of trying to say, hey, you are the only being in my industry, all those sweet nothings.
No. Yeah. But also, he didn't. Maybe it was because he was very real with me, yeah? He didn't try to impress me. Like the first, after that ride, when he told me he wanted to take me for lunch, he didn't take me to Java, Nini. He took me to, you remember that place that is between the Alchemist and Sarit on this side and this other side, I don't know what's the, it's now the Mövenpick, I think? Some hotel. This square that used to, triangle that used to be here. Ilikuwa moshi. Ukiingia huko lunchtime, you better be going home after that. June tanuka tu moshi. After he took me for lunch, na limitwa kwa ofisi. So I had to go back with smelling smoke. So we kula nyama and ugali, na kienyeji. I was like, for a first date, well, this guy is not pretending. Aiki ma level zingine, he's not. And I think that's where I think relationships start off on a wrong note. That you try and represent, and even at the band, Ulizakiatu, that's for real. You know, this guy does all these things to look like he can do and be, and chicks, we just chill for this guy who's just, we're age mates, or they could be younger than us, and then, you know, we expect so many things, all these other things from them, and they try. You guys, I'm not going to be DJ.